Hello and welcome in this tutorial. I want to teach you how you can make such an animation with Venetian blinds and a few tips and tricks in After Effects. Head on into the tutorial if you want to create such animations in minutes. Hello and welcome in this tutorial. Now I have a composition ready and I'll select from my toolbox a circle. Please click on this rectangle, hold a little longer and select the ellipse tool. Now once I have the ellipse tool, I'll select an ellipse in the middle. Maybe I do want to change the color, because I do have some colors prepared. I'll use a green like that. Okay, once I have the circle, I'll go to my align panel and select center, center. Okay, now I know that this one is in the middle. Once I have that, I'll click on it and I'll select Control or Command D to duplicate. And let's maybe say this will be the right one. I'll just hit enter and this will be the left one. Okay, now comes the fun. Please open up your title action save, so we will know where exactly is the middle of this composition. I'll come closer because I need to create two masks. For the left one, I want only the left to be visible, and for the right one, I want only the right to be visible. Okay, I'll select the left. I'll select a rectangle now, and you would create a second rectangle, but I don't want a rectangle, I want a mask to appear. This is why you need to click on this second button. Instead of creating a shape, you will create a mask. Okay, boom, select it. And by having the left selected, maybe deselect the right one, we will create a mask like that. I want to make sure that the mask is here visible until the middle. Okay, let's say that I hit the middle perfectly. I have mask number one. Now I'll select this mask, Control C, deselect the left one, select the right one. I'll open the right one and I'll press Ctrl V. This way I've pasted the exact same mask on the second object. Now the left one has mask one and the right one has mask one. What you need to do now is to select your move tool, double click on the mask and make sure that you make the mask like that. Just drag it to the right side and now you are sure that the right and left circle will be revealed like that. Okay, the main part is ready. Now I'll press U, I close everything down and I can work with my effect. This time my effect will be Venetian blinds. So go to Window, where do we have it? Effects and Presets. I'll call it Blinds and I'll double click the Venetian blinds. And what you can see, if you select a transition completion to 100, this is completely disappeared. If it goes to zero, it's completely visible. Now it's up to you, how do you want those blinds, which angle, how many the width. Maybe let's make the width 10, so we have more lines like that. And I'll also change the direction, well, to 50 degrees. Let's say this is okay. And okay, I have my effect prepared. And I want on the beginning, or maybe 5 frames forward, a transition completion of 100%. I'll click on the stopwatch to keyframe this. And 1 second later, I have here 5 frames. So I want to have 1 second and 5 frames. 1 second and 5 frames. Okay, you can see it on the left side. And at this point, I want it to be zero. So we will have an animation like that. Boom, perfect. Now I'll just copy this effect, Control C, go to the left one, and Ctrl V paste this item. Please select all layers and press U so you see the keyframes. Okay, the keyframes should be aligned, so I'll take the bottom keyframes and we'll align them like that. Boom, and we have the left and right circle which is appearing together. Perfect, a really nice effect. Now I want some animation going on. Let's maybe make the right from the top side and the left from the bot side. Let's once again hit U to select all keyframes. Now I want to animate backwards. I want to go to 1 second and 25 frames, okay. And I want to hit Shift P. Now I'll keyframe the position because this end keyframe is how the animation should look at the end. A bit earlier, the left one should go a bit up. Oh, sorry, the second value. And the right one a bit down. Okay, I think this is a nice animation. And now, since the right one was going down, at the beginning, it should go plenty up. The same for the left one. Since the left one was going up, now the left one should go down. Okay, perfect. And this is the animation which I wanted to achieve. Boom, boom. They come together, they shift a little bit, they overshoot, and then they stay in the right place. Okay, let's select those keyframes. Also those. Right click, keyframe assistant, ease them in, so they look a bit nicer. If this will be still too slow for you, please go into the graph editor and adjust them a little bit. I'll adjust them like that to go faster at the beginning. Here, here, a bit here. Okay, and this would be my initial animation. Now you can see that they are overshooting here a little bit. They should come to this point and now go down. But instead, they still go a little bit up. This can be adjusted by selecting this keyframe. Let's see where the circle is. I have this circle, these are the keyframes, and this is the problem, because I have a handle here. I need to pull the handle to this amount. Okay, now it will not overshoot, at least on one side. See, now we have to adjust the left one. Select the left one, come closer, and this keyframe is the problem. This keyframe has those handles, and those handles need to be pulled down. If you don't see the handles, I should even more pull it down. Okay, now it will be perfect. If you don't see the handles, please right click, keyframe interpolation, and change the spatial interpolation to continuous bezier. This will make the handles appear. Okay, now this animation should look proper and as I wanted it. Okay, it's nearly perfect. This is what I wanted mainly to show you, and now you can duplicate this object. 1, 2. Let me select the left alt key. Page down, page down, page down, Control D, page down, page down, page down, and we have a really fluent and nice animation. You see, this really looks cool. And you can also select everything with the Shift key, right click, pre-compose, press R to open up a rotation, and maybe rotate the circle a little bit. This will create a little different motion. At the very end, I went into this composition, and I've selected different colors for the first circle, the second circle, the third circle, and then the colors change. Also at the end, I made the last circles to fade off, so another color is revealed. In the grand scheme of things, we achieved an animation like that.